everyone, and welcome to another episode of DC Talks presents DC Academy, imparting ideas, insights, and innovation. My name is Ayan Gonzaga, also known as Boy Dubai, and again, I will be your host for tonight. And we all know that building a career from ground up is already a daunting task. How much more if we're talking about building your career outside your comfort zone or abroad? Tonight, we will be talking about all the things that are surrounding that particular topic. And before we proceed with our discussion, first, I would like to invite everybody to do check our videos here in DC Academy. Just visit Denarikash on Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube. As I've said, tonight, I will be joined by a very special guest. She is an HR manager in the UAE, has over 12 years of experience in the corporate human resources, strategic planning, and organization development. She is also hailed as one of the most influential Filipinos in the Gulf by Ilustrado magazine. Friends, ladies and gentlemen, let's all welcome Miss Cathy Ordoñez-Rivera. Hi, Cathy. Good evening. Thank you for joining us tonight.
Hello, Ayon. Good evening. Thank you for inviting me.
Yes, how are you these days?
Today, I just came from work, so just in time to arrive home.
Oh, okay. Since you just said that you came from work, and it is now our very topic for tonight, why don't we get the ball rolling by telling us a little bit of your background about your journey here in the UAE when it comes to work?
Okay, my HR journey in the United Arab Emirates. Actually, I have landed UAE, Abu Dhabi Airport in particular, last 27th of September 2008. So that's already 12 years today. So I was hired as an executive assistant / HR coordinator at that time. So I report directly to the managing director. I'm blessed to be working with the same company since 2008 today.
Wow.
Okay, so I've been working with them since 2008. So my HR career started when I joined the company as an HR coordinator. So I was tasked actually to build the HR team and to establish the HR department for the company. So my company is in a ready-mix concrete industry. So it belongs to a construction industry, 90% dominated by male. So it's a male-dominated industry. After 2 years of joining in 2010, I was promoted as an HR manager. So I've been working with them as an HR manager since 2010, handling the human resources department. On top of that, I'm also working like a QHSE in charge, if you may say so. I'm an audit, ISO certified auditor, lead auditor for the company. So I also monitor or manage and oversee the quality, health, safety, and environment functions of the company, which is, you know, a very kind of breath of fresh air for me. It's very fun and challenging to be working on that both department.
It's very interesting you shared that you are thriving in an environment dominated by men, and yet within 2 years you were able to be promoted as an HR manager. Can you take us back on what kind of journey, probably the environment or the attitude that you have during that time that led you into that kind of progress?
During those times talaga, my goal is to work in the United Arab Emirates and to establish a career here, particularly in the human resources department, and to help my family back home. So when I joined the company, I don't have anything in mind but to do my best to be successful in the field that I have chosen. I was, you know, the kind of person at the time, up to this time, very optimistic, very positive. I embrace change. I accept those challenges, whether big or small man yan. So I always try to improve myself as well.
You know, before we move further, what did you see as the stark differences between working here abroad and working back home in the Philippines?
okay, working back home in the Philippines is that is our comfort zone. So it's finally back for me, and everything you need is there. You have your family with you, you have your support system, you have your friends. Working in the Middle East is actually a totally different arena, especially for, as you've said, for a female like me, na joining an industry dominated by men. And considering also the culture that we have here in the Middle East. But you're working in an office, so most of the time there are men. And the language, okay, that we're actually the Arabic language plus the English language and different languages that you have here. So yun yung mga big changes that I need to adjust myself with during the start.
Yeah, yeah. But before you joined your company, with all these things that you are sharing right now, I believe that you are one competitive candidate during that time before the hiring.
And you know, I was lucky enough and blessed talaga to came across my employer, which they held their interviews in the Philippines back then. Ah. My background kasi is in the recruitment. Okay, so I do recruitment. I work for a recruitment company in the Philippines. So at that time, siguro pag para sa'yo talaga, you know, you will be led to that opportunity no matter what. So at that time, I was looking for employers who are gonna join job fairs in the Philippines. Kasi diba usong-uso sa atin ang job fairs.
Yeah.
So I was asked to look for employers, particularly mga recruitment agencies, to join us. And one of those recruitment agencies that I have contacted actually is holding an interview for an HR admin post at the time.
Okay.
So that was their last day of interview already. So ngayon, nagsubmit ako ng application ko. Kasi I was interested, and syempre with the package, with the salary and benefits. So, that's one of the factor why, sige, I'll try this opportunity na mag-apply. Kasi wala naman mawawala, di ba?
Right.
And right there and then, when I applied, yung employers kasi, there are many candidates, they were interviewed, but ang isa sa tumatak sa akin doon, you know, the question that they have asked me. And up to this time, yung manager ko na yun or yung employer ko na yun, tanda-tanda niya yung question na yun na tinanong niya sa akin. And you know, what is that question? Sabi niya, if you're gonna be hired for the position of human resources, how are you going to publish the department? So parang at that time parang, they are leading me or they are preparing me to perform the managerial role for that position.
I mean, compared to the typical questions that you get for HR interviews, like how do you see yourself 5 years from now?
Yes.
You have been asked specifically for the role that they see or probably see you doing in the future.
Yes, exactly. Kasi nakakagulat. And you know what? I answered them. Of course, it's not a one-man show. Okay? In order for you to establish a department, you have to collaborate and cooperate and to work well with the team.
Yeah.
So probably that element they saw in me, plus the, you know, the charm, probably na having a lady naman sa kanilang department would bring a positive change sa organization dominated by men.
At the end of the day, who run the world, di ba? As that okay, but Cathy, fast forward, you are already here and you see the plight of many Filipinos or other nationalities going abroad. Not all of them start the way you did, you know, having that interview in your home country before eventually flying over here. Would you reckon, especially during these times, that they do the same thing to wait and find an opportunity while they are still in their home countries before traveling here?
Okay, for me kasi, if you wanted to work abroad and you wanted to be successful, expect na it will not be an easy journey for you. It's not always what you saw on social media. It's not always what you read on newspapers and all these things, okay? First and foremost, you have to prepare yourself, okay? You have to embrace that you will be working overseas and there's no one to help you except yourself. coming here, you have to find your biggest why.
Mm-hmm.
Why do you want to work abroad? Why do you want to sacrifice working here away from your family? Kasi yeah. that will make you growing. Alam mo yun? That will serve as your motivation, your inspiration to work hard here. Kasi maraming temptations working abroad. To be honest. Okay? But if you know your biggest why, you will stay focused towards achieving, first and foremost, your goal and your why in the first place. And additional advice also for those, or additional tip for those who are going to work here, know the country that you're going to work with. Read about their culture, about the language, you know, about law, probably on that countries. At least you're ready when you step, you know.
Indeed, learning never stops, even if you get landed on a job that you wish for, or sometimes you don't really expect, as you've shared. It involves learning the language, the culture, probably skills that will make you or that will help you climb up the ladder. Cathy, if you can again take us back to how did you get yourself learning continuously? What are the methodologies that you've done, probably the resources that you have consulted? If you can share those things with our viewers tonight, probably they could also get encouraged.
So with my HR journey, or with my HR career in the United Arab Emirates or in the UAE, actually the Filipino Human Resources Practitioners Association, or PhilHR, plays very significant role talaga. Kasi that is where I found my second family. You know, it's an organization of all HR professionals, HR practitioners. From there, nakakita ako doon ng mga mentors. Alam mo yon, from there, we were able to have an access to HR best practices.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, it doesn't end there. Siyempre, you have to help yourself. You have to continuously improve your skills. You have to continuously update whatever best practices that you already know to stay competitive in the market. So I undergo certifications. I studied human resources diploma here in Cambridge University in Dubai. Uh-huh. So I attended several trainings talaga when it comes to human resources. I've learned other specializations. I was also an ISO lead auditor. Continuously strive to improve yourself. Yeah. Education or learning never stops for you here.
Mm-hmm.
Competitive in this kind of very competitive environment, especially in the Middle East. Kasi ang daming magagaling talaga dito.
True. And speaking of adaming magagaling dito, is it a myth or a fact that in addition to getting a higher pay scale here, is it true that it's indeed or way easier to find a job here in the UAE compared to our home country?
I think so. And when it comes to pay structure, yes. Your pay structure, it corresponds to your qualifications, your competencies. But take note, most of the employers hired attitude more than your education background or your experiences and all. So first and foremost talaga, very important that you have the right attitude for you towards performing the job that you're actually applying for.
I would agree to that. And speaking of attitude, you mentioned also PhilHR earlier. How do you strike a balance between, you know, family, career, the expat community, and everything else that you have to juggle day in and day out?
You can always tell me na ako na yung babaeng walang pahinga kasi always be on the go. Mm. Pero it's a matter of priorities. Kasi di ba sabi ko, at the end of the day, you should know your why you are here. So if you know your why, you can align those priorities towards achieving that. You can align those priorities towards achieving that. And if your career and you have your family and you have the community and those are part of your biggest why and your priorities, you can definitely find time to spend to each one of those.
So you mentioned hundreds of things already, and they're all really good advices. But if you have to give one word to someone who are thinking of traveling abroad to work, what would be your biggest advice?
Okay, for me, I would say it's not the biggest advice, because some things may work for me but may not work for you in, in some ways. So I would just give you like what I have learned, okay, and share with you, and you might probably, you know, take note of that in the future. Working here and abroad, you have to find your biggest why. Okay, why do you want to work abroad, and why do you want to sacrifice working away from your family here? And stay focused towards achieving that one. That's the most important thing. There will be a lot of temptations. You might be redirected to different directions or whatsoever, but you have to go back, refocus, review, check, and validate what is your why in the first place. Why are you here? Because yeah, there are a lot of us, especially those other people. I don't want to speak on majority, diba? Baka mahold and code. So, pero dito kasi it's it's a lifestyle. Alam mo yon, dali-dali ng lifestyle dito, and you have so many access to bank loans, credit cards, diba? I would touch that, okay? That topic. But at the end of the day, please, you have to talaga to know why are you here in the first place, and to focus on those whys, and to avoid those temptations that might derail you from achieving your whys.
Wow. I would have to agree on all of those things. Very beautiful indeed. Very well said, Cathy. Why indeed do you want to travel in Dubai or anywhere else in the world? Why would you leave your comfort zone? Why? You have to repeatedly ask yourself and find answers to those whys, because at the end of the day, your answer will be the reasons that will sustain you, that will enable you to keep going, that will allow you to wake up with energy, with enthusiasm every morning, despite of the challenges that will come your way, despite of the temptations, as Cathy was saying, you know, that might derail your plans, that might derail your goal. As long as you always add purpose to your passion, you will always be sure that you are on the right track, that you have a goal that you are aiming to achieve. That's why you have decided to work abroad. Again, Cathy, thank you so much for all those beautiful insights. Do you have anything else to add to that?
Okay, aside from your biggest why, okay, don't forget that you can always achieve your dream. So always remember that whatever your mind can imagine, you can definitely achieve it. So sky's the limit, guys. Yeah. So do not limit yourself.
It's a nice word of inspiration once again. Cathy walk us through to her stories, and all I can take away from that is the attitude. The attitude will be the reason, the main reason for you to get through, for you to climb up that ladder, for you to progress in your plans, in achieving those plans. It may not fit, and whatever works for her might not completely fit all of us, but definitely she inspires us to find whatever will fit for us. That's it for tonight, guys. I hope you had a great time listening to the insights of Cathy. Thank you for allowing yourself to be an inspiration to our viewers tonight.
Thank you so much for inviting me, and thank you to Dinari Cash for always thinking of me to be part of their Dinari initiative.
Thank you once again for tuning in. And if you want to learn more about what Cathy shared to us tonight, simply send us a message or leave a comment in the video below. This has been DC Talks Presents DC Academy, imparting ideas, insights, and innovations. My name is Ian Gonzaga, your host for tonight. Thank you for watching. Good night.